The next step is coloring the illustration. First, I create a new layer and place it all the way below the line drawing. Next, I select the Fill tool, and in the Subtool palette, I choose Refer Other Layers. Then, I choose a color from the color palette, and I can start coloring in. If there are small gaps between lines that prevent you from coloring with the Fill tool, try turning on Close Gap in the Tool Properties palette. This takes care of small gaps and makes it easy to fill in colors. If you want to change the color at a later time, just select the color you want to change it to and select Change Color of Line Color to Drawing from the Edit menu in the command bar. Next, I'll color the hair. By separating the layers for each color, I can edit and change the painted colors later. If I find parts that are left uncolored, I simply use the eyedropper tool, choose the color and paint it again. If there are small parts that are hard to fill with the normal fill tool, choose the Close and Fill or Paint and Fill Areas tools from the Subtool palette. As the number of layers increases, it gets harder to manage them all, so it's a good idea to create a dedicated folder for the color layers. Once done, the next thing I'll do is painting the shadows. I create a new layer above the color layer for the shadows and set the blend mode to multiply. After selecting a slightly brighter color, I start painting the shadows. Since the colors are going past the base colors, I also click the Clip at Layer Below icon in the layer palette. By clipping a layer to the one below, the drawn colors will not go past the color of the layer below. For each part, I'm changing the color of the shadow individually. I'm going to choose a color that is a bit more red than the previous shadow color. In the layer palette, I click the layer with the hair's color and by selecting Create Selection under Selection from Layer in the layer menu, I select only the hair. With that, only the area that has the painted hair color is selected. Next, I choose the layer with the shadows in the layer palette. With the Selection Launcher Fill tool, I fill in the new color for the shadow. I then clear the selection in the launcher, and this is how the shadow color of the hair can be changed easily. In the same way, I change the shadows for the skin. Once the shadows are done, I hide the layer temporarily. In the next step, I'm going to add some blush to the cheeks, for which I create a new layer and apply a soft red color with a soft subtool of the airbrush tool. Above the hair layer, I create a new layer and clip it to the hair layer. With that done, I pick up the color of the jacket with the eyedropper tool to draw the pink strands of the hair. The next thing to draw are the highlights. As I did with the shadows, I'm going to clip a new layer above the other color layers and draw the highlights. I choose colors that are lighter than the base colors and draw them with the pen tool. Then, I make the shadows visible again and check the image as a whole. After that, I put the line work into a folder. Lastly, I change the line color of the character by selecting the line layer folder and changing the layer color in the layer property palette to make it more interesting. Once the character is completed, it's time for the background. For this, I create a layer and move it underneath the illustration of the character, and then click Select All from the selection menu in the command bar. The selection launcher will appear, and I am going to select a green color and then click the Fill tool. After that, I cancel the current selection and select different parts with the lasso tool. I delete the selected area with the delete button of the selection launcher. From the tool palette, I choose the decoration tool, select the pattern group, and use the star brush to add the effect in white to the background. And with that, the illustration is done.